first I wanted to be super aggressive with my fitness journey. And then I went to the gym. I'm going to humble myself and stick where I am at. Or welcome back to my channel. My name is Janae if you are new, and welcome to a new video. I make content centered around my weight loss journey, beauty, and lifestyle, and I hope you subscribe. So you guys, on today's video is going to be my workout routine, how I am going to be training my body and jump starting my fitness journey. So if you're interested to hear my plan of action as far as my fitness and my workouts and how I plan to lose weight by moving my body, then just keep on watching. We are a couple of weeks in 2022. I have been working out, trying new things, figuring out how my body is reacting to it. And I think I finally got a flow, at least for the first couple of months. So you guys, I really gave this some thought because at first I was going to go about it super aggressively. That was not about to cut it at all. So after sitting down and humbling myself and realizing that I need to move at the pace that my body is at right now, I decided to scale back just a little bit. For at least January and February, I want to take my fitness journey about 2 months at a time. That way I really have a good amount of time to see how my body is adjusting and changing and growing stronger. So you guys, I have my phone here for reference because when it comes to fitness, I don't write anything down in a book. I write it in my notes. And that's just a little tip for you guys. I see people walking around with a book, and if it works for you, great. But for me, I like to put it right in my notes. So I just made a little folder for my workouts, and I label each month. So month to month, if I change up my routine or if I increase in weights, then I have a record of how I am progressing. For right now, I'm going to have 4 weight training days per week. And those 4 weight training days are going to be a push day, a pull day, a leg day, and then a total body day where I'm working on all the muscle groups over here. So for my push day, it's going to be triceps, shoulders, and chest, and that will be Mondays. On my pull days, it's going to be back and biceps. That's going to be Tuesday. Wednesday, I'll just do cardio. Thursday is going to be my leg and booty days. And Friday is going to be, again, total body. Saturday is going to be an all cardio day, and then Sunday is going to be a rest day, but kind of like an active rest day where I am stretching, I'm foam rolling, I am finding a yoga video, something very mellow, but I'm still prioritizing movement. So that is 6 days per week that I am going to be working out. That is what I have as a plan. If I need to take 1 extra rest day, I will. I will allow myself to have 2 rest days per week on a cardio day, not a weight training day, but that is going to be it. So I think I talked about this before where my workouts are normally 1.5 to 2 hours per day. So for sure, 4 days a week, I know I'm going to do 2 hours, maybe a little bit over 2 hours, because not only am I doing weight training on my weight training days, I'm going to be doing cardio as well. I'm going to be doing at least 1 hour of cardio 6 days per week. So as far as cardio is concerned, what I plan on doing is the elliptical only. After these last few weeks figuring out how my body has been moving and my knee is aching, definitely don't want to run at all. Definitely don't want to do the stairs because of that friction for my knee. The bike, I really don't burn enough calories for me to sit and do that, but I will maybe as a warm up or a cool down here or there, or if I just want to switch it up. but I really don't see myself getting on the bike. And I may do some walking. I may go on the treadmill and do a light incline, a light pace, something like that. But my plan of action right now is to prioritize the elliptical. It doesn't give me any stress with my knees whatsoever. I can still move my arms, still in a walking or running type of stride to get me prepared for walking and eventually running, because that is one of my fitness goals for the year, is to start running. So that's why my priority is going to be the elliptical with a little bit of walking. As far as my abs are concerned, I plan on doing abs at least 3 days per week, and not to cut body fat or to get abs. It's really so that I can strengthen my core, because I realized that I need to have a strong core to do everything else. I need to like really have a strong core. So I want to focus on that. So my ab days are going to be on Wednesdays and Saturdays for sure, which are my two cardio days. And one of the weight training days. I'm not sure which weight training day yet, but one of the weight training days, probably the one that's going to take me the fastest to do, which is back and biceps day. That's normally my fastest day. So yes, I plan on doing 3 days a week for abs, Wednesdays, Saturdays, and Tuesdays. So that is the plan of action as far as my, what I'm gonna be doing, what days I'm gonna be doing, and all that good stuff. As far as how many calories I want to burn, because I'm still trying to wrap my mind under this whole calorie deficit thing where, you know, I have a set level of maintenance calories. Obviously, I eat below that to be in a calorie deficit, but also I'm moving my body to be in a calorie deficit. So I'm still trying to wrap my mind around how that whole number thing works. But I want to burn at least 500 active calories every time I go to the gym. And I use an Apple Watch, so that tracks my workouts for me, and it tells me how many calories I'm burning and then how many active calories I'm burning. And I want to burn at least 500 active calories, because if I'm working out 6 days a week, 500 calories, that's 3,000 calories, and 1 pound of fat is 3,500 calories. I mean, I'm already in a calorie deficit by striving for that 500 calorie mark. And then with me eating in a calorie deficit, I know I will at least get 1 to 2 pounds loss per week, which may seem slow to a lot of people, especially at the weight that I'm at. But this isn't a race for me. I'm trying to do things a lot differently this time around, because obviously I wasn't successful before in the methods I was doing before, when I was losing 3, 5, 6 pounds in a week. I wasn't doing things the right way before. So I am good with 1 or 2 pounds a week as long as I keep myself consistent with what I plan on doing. So I really want to prioritize being consistent. That is such a downfall for me. My consistency is not there at all. So I want to ensure that for these next couple of months, I am being consistent with what I'm telling you guys that I'm going to do right here. And of course, I will let you guys know in my weekly weigh-ins if I'm sticking to what I'm telling you guys that I'm going to stick to. As we get closer to March and April, I think I'm gonna do an updated video for you guys on my fitness routine and what I decided to change when I get there. And then I think every couple of months, it's gonna be a new updated fitness video for you guys. I think I'm also going to bring my camera to the gym and actually record my workouts and showing you guys what exactly it is that I'm doing, if you would like to follow along. Everything I'm doing is very, very basic and very beginner's friendly, women friendly, all of that good stuff. So I want to actually show you guys in a series of videos what it is that I am doing. That way you can put it in a playlist and take it with you to the gym, because I know sometimes you're trying to figure out a workout and then you go to someone's page and they can get real left field really quickly. But it's nice to see someone that's in your position doing the things that you want to do. So that's why I want to record it for you guys. So let me know in the comment section below if that's something that you guys will be interested in, and throw all your questions, all of that good stuff down in the comment section below. Okay, you guys, so that is it for this video. Really short and simple. I just wanted to give you guys where I'm at as far as my fitness is concerned, because I think I touched on a couple of different things already in my weight loss journey, but I haven't given you guys any fitness content yet, and it is a big part of my weight loss journey. So I want to start giving you guys that as well. Now, even though I am a certified personal trainer, I am not no fitness guru. I'm sure I'm going to make plenty of mistakes. I know for sure I need to work on my form, and we will get there. We will get there. So constructive criticism is always welcome, but just be kind, because I'm gonna be kind to you either way. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon. That way you're notified every single time I post a new video. Comment down below if you are on a weight loss journey. Are you adding fitness into your journey? Are you just going to focus on your meals? Are you going to the gym? Are you doing at home? Let me know in the comment section below. Make sure you guys follow me on my Instagram and my TikTok. I'll put the handles for both right here. This is where you're going to see more of a day-to-day or short form videos of what it is that I'm doing when it comes to my what I eat in a day, my workout of the day, all of that good stuff. So make sure you go ahead and follow me over there. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.